The part two carnival banner is here, but who should you spend your hard-earned carnival coins on? How's it, everybody? Celtic Link here. We're back for another Dokkan battle video. In today's video, we are taking a look at the part two Gamma 1 and Gamma 2 carnival banner on Dokkan's 9th anniversary and answering that age-old question, who should you choose with your carnival coins? Now, carnival coins are a very, very scarce currency right now because these banners haven't been around very long, unlike Dokkan Fest or Yellow Coin banners, which, you know, are also pretty scarce because most people don't summon on those banners, right? Carnival coins are very, very limited because these banners are still fairly new, right? They were introduced in 2022 with the Cooler Movie Goku and Metal Cooler, and they've only come around a couple times a year. Like that year, the only other carnival banner was for Global was Int Zamas, and then JP got the STR Super Saiyan Goku from the Planet Eradicate Saiyans, and then the next carnival banner after that was Anniversary, and then Worldwide, and then Omega Shenron, right? So I haven't been too many banners. So as such, right, possibly this anniversary, if you've been summoning on the carnival banners during anniversaries and worldwide, most players are probably coming around there for, unless you typically do a lot of summoning, are probably coming around their first chance to pick up a unit with 500 coins at this point. So the question is, which ones is worth it? Well, let's say first and foremost, before we talk about that, if you did not summon Super Saiyan Blue Gogeta, or you did not summon the Gamma 1 and Gamma 2, then you need to save your carnival coins until they return, whenever that might be. As the next likely return, if we're lucky, will be in December with whatever that part 2 LR is. They might do like they did with Omega and replace them on AGL Full Power Jiren's banner, right? They might just replace these two. Well, actually, I hope they don't replace this guy, but these guys might be moved onto the worldwide banner for Global, so we'll talk about them in a minute. But like they did with Omega Shenron, they might put these guys on Jiren's banner whenever that pops up, as they did with Kai Goku and Kid Gohan. So with that out of the way, right, you save your coins if you didn't get these guys. Who is worth it off of this banner? Well, there's several units here, right? You'll notice that there are carnival units available. There are the three units you can currently buy. Future Gohan, Kai Goku, and Birdku, right? You can buy these three units for 500 carnival coins, or you can buy one of these three yellow coin LRs. Now, last in the part one video, I did recommend Broly Trio if you had absolutely everything else and you had full intention, right? You had enough to coin these guys as well, should you not summon them, and you did get your copy of Broly. This banner, I'm not making that recommendation. There's no easy ALR here that's worth it, and Bulma, while is very good, she's been starting to pop up a lot lately on banners, so, right, I wouldn't go out of your way to get her, unlike Broly Trio, whose easy A is almost necessary to run a proper Super Bosses team. So, just throwing that out there. And then, of course, you have three banner units, which, of course, I don't recommend you using on. So, of the carnival units, which ones should you use? Well, first and foremost, right, we have the AGL Kai Goku. So in no particular order here, right, AGL Kai Goku, this is his second return on Global. His first return, as I said, was on Omega Shenron's banner, and he's honestly pretty good. He can build up, he can stack defense, right? So these longer events are really, really useful to him. And of course, right, for the first six turns, he's got guard, which will help him get that stack a little bit easier. So honestly, right, he's still pretty useful. He has a survive KO mechanic. He does nullify key last supers, which there are quite a few of in some of these newer events. So he's still got a lot of use and can be incredibly useful to many new players to fill out several teams. Right, he's on a lot of, you know, pretty staple teams, right? Pure Saiyan, Full Power, that's Broly's team, right? Goku's family, always going to be a powerful team. Final Trump card, Bond of Parent and Child, Earthbred Fighters, and then, of course, Power of Wishes. Well, not in its heyday anymore, it's still a fairly decently powerful category, right? So he's not that terrible. Otherwise, other units on the banner include the STR Super Saiyan Gohan, right? Future Gohan is incredibly useful in short event content. As long as there are short event contents, he has a place. He doesn't do so well in long events, right? Because once his passive runs out, and he doesn't get to do anything in his domain, he becomes a bit squishy, right? So he's definitely a short event character. Some of the newer events in, like, on JP, right, in the first half of the events where they're all fairly short, he can do well, right? But once you start getting past turn 5 into turns 6, 7, 8, you gotta play around him, make sure your protection skills are up, but he could still do some pretty decent damage and honestly offer, you know, a domain for your super class characters. So he is decently useful. So otherwise, the only other carnival unit is the LR Birdku. Now, at this point, I do not recommend purchasing him over the other two, simply because he's just a bit too old. You're not going to get much use out of them, except intentionally using him to proc a revive for another character. But there are better options at this point to do that, right? So, honestly, the best choices here are Kai Goku and Future Gohan. And if I would say there was a clear choice, it is Future Gohan. A lot of people are going to, bring him down for, you know, not being as good in the longer content, but that that doesn't mean he's not still good. I've used him in every event so far in the 9th anniversary to relative success, you know, as long as you play around that loss after turn 5 and you have your protection mechanics up, or you just plan on floating him off. He'll still do decently well after his 18 key. He just can't go slot 1 after that point, which I think is what a lot of people try to do with him. So you do want to make sure that you are playing around that. So he is definitely your number one pick if you already have the gammas, or at least you have enough to coin them later. Otherwise, there are some special considerations, right? Number one, he will return in a month. So if you want, you can wait a month and pick him up at the end of August when he returns during Worldwide Celebration. But I always say this, right? If that is your plan, just be aware, make sure you do in fact coin him if you don't get him during Worldwide, because I have made this mistake before. I said, hey, no, I'm not going to purchase Buhan for my red coins during his return on the 6th Annie, and then I ended up not being able to get him during Worldwide that year, and then it wasn't until 7th anniversary that I was able to pick up my first copy of LR Buhan. So it's, you know, almost 2 years later at that point. So it's like, you know, just be aware, if you're gonna do it, make sure you do it then, if you don't end up pulling them. So just keep that in the back of your head. Now, I would say if you are missing other units, maybe try to prioritize them. Like, these guys should be returning during Worldwide, or like I said, on Jiren's banner. Whenever that's happening, you know, nobody knows when that's gonna happen. But I would definitely say do that. Maybe focus on picking these guys up. And I only say that is because Gohan's going to show up far as a Worldwide unit. Gohan's going to appear far more often than these guys are, right? These guys may see a once, maybe if we're lucky, twice a year return. But so far, right, Global hasn't seen these guys again. And I doubt JP is going to see them on the Worldwide Celebration. So that pretty much means, you know, they only get one return a year. So if you're missing them, I would definitely say maybe hold some coins off for them instead of Future Gohan, as he could possibly show up. Or if you want to play the long game, right, save your coins entirely for the gammas, or just in case you don't summon Jiren, right? You may be somebody who wants Jiren but isn't planning on summoning him whenever that banner comes, just because there's other priorities like 10th anniversary for you. So, right, you may want to just save your coins altogether until this guy makes his debut. But as the part 2 carnival LR, right, you may not, we don't know when we might see him again, right? Omega Shenron still hasn't shown up again, and there's a good chance he's showing up on Worldwide for JP, but unlikely for Global, right? So just be aware of those considerations. But overall, my recommendation off of this banner is definitely LR Future Gohan. And then, of course, if you didn't summon the Gammas, then just save for them. So, guys, that is it for the video. If you like the video, make sure you hit that like button and subscribe to the channel if you have not already. And in the comments down below, let us know, who did you pick with your hard-earned Carnival coins? Honestly, I'm considering just go ahead and grabbing my last dupe of him so I can do a rainbow showcase, right? I pulled him to 90% from 69%, I think, off of the Gamma's banner, so might be willing to do that for a rainbow showcase. But otherwise, I would just probably save my coins. But I'm curious what you guys plan on doing. Let us know in the comments down below. Otherwise, guys, as always, thanks for watching, and aloha.